Hi guys, in this particular example, we're going to be playing with Pythagoras' theorem in order to work out the missing pronumeral along here on this right-angled triangle. Now, first of all, let's take a closer look at this right-angled triangle. We know it's right-angled because we have the 90 degrees right there. So we have this very long length across here. Now, do you remember what that's called? For those of you who don't remember, it's called the hypotenuse. That's the long length not attached to the right angle. And then we have two other lengths that are attached to the right angle. Over here we have 12 and over here we have k. So what are the three steps? Step number one, we write down the Pythagorean equation. Step number two, we drag and drop or substitute the values we have into the equation. And finally, the last step is we take square roots to both sides and we can come up with what k is. So let's go through the three steps. What's step number one again? We write down the equation. That's right. So let's do that. So it's a squared plus b squared equals c squared. Noting this c squared right over here is the long length called hypotenuse. That's the 15 right there. So let's substitute now. That's the next step. So let's take that 15 and put it in right over here. So that's going to become 15 squared right there. And then we're going to take the b squared from right over there. Let's bring it across here. So that's going to be 12 squared. And finally, we're the missing pronumeral. We're looking for k, aren't we? So let's put k right over here. And that's going to be k squared. So let's check and point that we've substituted correctly into the equation. So the 15 squared, the hypotenuse, that's right there. That's the long length, confirming, yes, it is the long length. Then we have 12 squared, right there. There's that length right there. And finally, k squared, the missing pronumeral, here it is sitting right over there. So now let's expand the squares. So that's going to give us k squared plus, now 12 squared on the calculator, or if you remember, 12 times 12 is 144. And that equals 15 squared. And that's going to be 225. Okay, let's take away 144 from both sides so we can get k squared by the side by itself. So we're going to take this number here, 144, and bring it over to that side. We're going to take it away. So let's take away 144, and we do the same on the other side of the equals. Take away 144. Okay, so these guys eliminate. Okay, so they're gone. I'll cross that out, cross that out. And then we're left on the right-hand side here, 225. Take away 144 on your calculator will give you 81. So let's write that down here, 81. Now let's bring the k squared down here. Okay, so let's drag it down here. So that's k squared equals 81. Now remember the final step in Pythagorean theorem is to take the square root of both sides. So let's do that. Square root here and square root there. Now when we take the square root of k squared, that reverts to just being k. There it is. And then the square root of 81 is the answer to this length right there. What k is
1. Take a minute to check out our website at http://www.vividmaths.com. You'll find additional resources, cheat sheets, transcripts, and other maths videos that are not available on YouTube. Lastly, don't forget to subscribe to get access to all the written answers for your maths questions, plus other special offers.